I want to have you turn to page 7 and 8 in your book. The first organization is called Inca Link International. And the simple introduction I'm going to give you is this. Rich was born in Ecuador. His parents were from the U.S. Elisa was born in Argentina. By the way, she asked me if she could wear her Argentina jersey today. I told her she could, but she chose not to. She's a very proud Argentine. And her parents are from Canada. Two of their four kids were born in Peru. They have 22 passports in their family, a very United Nations family. We're excited to welcome Rich and Lisa to the stage to introduce us to Inca Link International.
Thank you. Thank you, Russ. Thank you. Good morning.
We're super excited to be here. Thank you, Russ, for inviting us. And we could tell you stories of growing up with Russ, playing drums together, motorcycles, guns? No, not guns. No, don't say that. Had a great time in Ecuador growing up together, but it was an amazing day when Russ helped us take a step back and figure out why these 22 passports were so important to us. Lisa and I, when we got married, said one thing we don't want to do is work with young people. And God called us to be youth pastors in Raleigh, North Carolina. Then we went to Peru, gave it up. Now we're going to be real missionaries. They asked us to be youth pastors. And today, years later, we know why God's put us on this earth. It's to reach the 300 million youth of Latin America, linking all those passports and contacts together for the love of Jesus. But before we tell you about Inca Link, we like to always start off thinking and remembering the goodness of God. I'm going to just give you 10 seconds, 15 seconds, to talk to the person next to you. When have you seen the goodness of God in 2023? 30 seconds. There you go, 15 each. Okay, 15 more seconds, swap people. Okay, did you see the goodness of God in 2023? Lisa and I saw the goodness of God in being able to go serve with our adult children in Ushuaia, Argentina. We got to serve again together. That was a blessing for me. How about for you?
Well, I have to say that Argentina won the World Cup, but
that was last year.
Yes, but it was a hand of God because it was a miracle. If you watch,
I don't
last
think God
game,
was involved in that.
I was
one.
Like, oh my goodness, heart attack.
Messi won his World Cup.
God is working all the time, isn't he? And sometimes he just surprises us with the places that he takes us. For Rich and I, we never expected to be doing what we're doing. We went on the field as traditional missionaries. We were church planting, teaching in the seminary, much like our parents did. But God convicted us about so many youth in Latin America who would never darken the door of a church. And I remember we went with our youth group to the garbage dump in Trujillo, Peru, where we were living. And there God said, I need you to be my hands and feet with these people. And our whole organization, Inca Link, was born in that moment with the commitment of us, but also of our youth group leaders who said, we didn't even know this existed in our city. And so now we are about to celebrate 17 years. We have a daycare center in the garbage dump in Trujillo, Peru. And we take the kids out of the garbage while their parents are mining and recycling in the garbage. We have their kids. We feed them good meals. We talk to them about the hope that we have in Jesus. We make sure they have documents. Most of them are undocumented. They don't even exist. And so we get them their documentation, we get them into school, and then, of course, we have to help them catch up and learn how to read and write, all those things. And then we also love to just have fun, because it's good for the soul to have some fun, right? One year we decided we would take the kids to go see a movie. Ice Age was playing, and we thought they would love it. So we piled them into the bus, and we took them to the movie theater, and they were so excited. And you know those seats that recline in the movie theater, they're so cool. The movie started and they reacted like any other kid would. They loved Ice Age and that little squirrel that keeps losing his acorn. They were loving it. In the middle of the movie, one of our youngest kids, he had to go to the bathroom. So he went to the leader. He said, "I have to go to the bathroom. Did you bring the shovel?" Why did he ask for a shovel? Well, in their context, it's all sand. Trujillo's a desert, and they're on the outskirts, so all they see is sand. And their homes, barely can we call them homes. They don't have any running water or electricity or anything like that. Of course, they don't have bathrooms, but they do have a shovel. They go outside, they dig a hole, do their necessities, use the shovel to cover it back up, and then bring it back inside. So the leader said, "No, I didn't bring the shovel, but I'm going to take you to the bathroom." And he took this little boy for the first time in his life to a modern bathroom. Little boy was overwhelmed. He showed him the toilet. He said, "This is how you use it." The little boy used it. And as he's coming out of the stall, the leader says, "But now you have to wash your hands." So the little boy goes back in and is about to put his hands in the toilet. He's like, "No, no, not there." He brings him to the sink. He turns on the faucet and water runs out. And this little boy's eyes grew huge. Where is this water coming from? Where's the bucket? Turns it off, turns it on again. The water is still running. Turns it off, turns it on again. There's still water there. He starts putting his hand in there. He washes his hands. He starts drinking and drinking and drinking from that water. Then he washes his face, his hair, his body. He's like, "This water, it never runs out. It never runs out." And before the leader can react, he goes running into back into the movie theater, interrupts the whole movie, yells at his friends, "Chicos, chicos, this is great, but I found something even better. Come with me." They all run out of the movie, follow him. They go into the bathroom, and it's the same scene over again. These kids drinking from this water, marveled at this water that never runs dry. And us, the leaders, were standing at the door of the bathroom watching this, crying. Of course. What a blessing to see that. And we couldn't help but think about Jesus and his words where he said, "Oh, you'll drink from the water that the world will give you, but you'll always thirst again. But if you drink from my water, you will never thirst again."
We at IncaLink want to keep the faucet running and allow Jesus to touch people's lives and continue to give them that water, that living water. And we're trying to reach 300 million youth of Latin America. Put a thumbs up if you have a child or a grandchild that's 0 to 25 years old. Anybody out there? All right. Imagine all those kids speaking Spanish or Portuguese. That's our mission field. Anybody 0 to 25 years old, we're trying to reach them for Jesus and allow them to drink from the faucet. And people say, "Well, how in the world can you do that? That's too many. How are you going to reach 300 million youth?" Thankfully, we don't have to reach them. We just have to turn on the faucet. We just have to keep it running. We do it four ways. If you don't mind helping me with your fingers today and your hands, everybody hold up your hands like this. Four ways to reach 300 million youth of Latin America that the Lord's using with us. One is contextualized evangelism. We have to reach them where they are in their situation. If you look at the back of your hand, the thumb is discipleship. Discipleship's through all of it, okay? So evangelism, contextualized evangelism. Number two, keep your hands up. I know they're super heavy. Training leaders. We can't reach 300 million by ourselves. We got to train others to help. Third is connecting people, short-term missions to have a long-term impact. And number four, social work, teen pregnancy homes and garbage dump daycare centers. Turn your hand upside down. The social work attracts the short-term teams. We charge our short-term teams a little bit more, and we involve them to help us reach and train the leaders and do the evangelism and discipleship. You can rest your arms. I know it's super heavy. We did it. We did it. People say, "Well, what kind of ministries do you do to reach 300 million youth?" We like to say we're more like Target or Walmart than Coca-Cola or Pepsi. I know people like Coke and I do too, but we don't franchise one ministry. Any kind of product, in our case, any kind of ministry that'll help us reach 300 million youth of Latin America, that's what we want to do. So we have professional sports teams. We have adventure camps. We have daycare centers. We have Inca Arte in Costa Rica. Anything that'll help us reach the youth of Latin America. And so We don't just franchise one. And then our goal has been, and when we started, Lisa talked about starting in Peru, it quickly spread over to Ecuador and Colombia, and the United States became like a funnel of resources to help us get to the people that were in need. And then we started a 2020 vision in 2020, really creative, right? And it was to reach 10 new countries, open 10 new countries in 10 years. So then we opened up Costa Rica and Honduras and Guatemala and Mexico. And our Mexico people, some of our Mexico people are here today. Raise your hands, our Mexico people. There they are, the Burgess. And then we still have 7 more countries to 2030 that we need to get to. And these are some of the rest of the countries that we're looking at going to. To go, to reach 300 million youth of Latin America, we have to go where the youth are. And that's what we're trying to do.
Our mode of operations then really is from an old book that we studied with our youth group when we were early missionaries. It's an old book by Blackaby called Experiencing God, Mi Experiencia con Dios. I don't know if you've read it. It's so good. I highly recommend it. And in that book, Blackaby talks about we shouldn't be making our plans and then asking God to bless those plans, but we should train our eyes and our ears to see and hear what God is doing around us and then step into what he's already doing, and then we'll be under the umbrella of his blessing, right? We're in his presence. And so that's how we decide. Every country, every project that we do, it's based on what is God already doing? How can we come alongside and be a part of what he's doing?
Some of you know the S-curve. We started in 2006, 17 years later. We've had amazing growth, 35 missionaries that raised their support from 9 countries that are serving around the continent. A lot of growth, but we're also seeing a lot of transition now. We're at the S-curve. We got to reinvent ourselves again, and we're reimagining how we're doing short-term missions to have a long-term impact. And we're seeing people leave and go to other organizations that they're called to. We're also seeing people come flooding to the organization, and we want to be good stewards of that. And as we reach this God-sized goal, you can be involved. You can help us keep the faucet running. You can help get the needs, the resources to the people. In your booklets, if you look at page 9, we have the some of the ways you can get involved. We're just going to highlight quickly 3 of them. Wisdom and guidance. The experience that God has given you in your life can help us. Your expertise can really be helpful to us. And look through those options. Second, visiting and co-laboring. Come see for yourselves. Raise your hand if you attend a church somewhere. Bring your church. Bring your church. We'd love to have you come and check it out and see what God is doing with the faucet running in Latin America. And maybe if you can't come, send other people. Schools or colleges or sports teams. We tailor make our short-term missions to fit what you need, but we also plug you into what God's doing in Latin America. And then 3, maximize your network. Who do you know? As we've been talking, maybe God brought to your mind someone. You know what? So-and-so might be a good fit for Inca Link as they reach youth in Latin America. Connect them with us. Who would they be? Maybe it's you, yourself, or a family member. But we'd love to hear from your network who God brings to your mind to serve with us. We have all kinds of needs. We need guest house operators in Ecuador, Quito, Ecuador. Maybe it's just for the summers, or maybe it's long-term, or teen pregnancy homes. Or we just need missionaries all the way around. If we're going to reach 300 million youth, we have to send people. And so as God brings people to your mind, child sponsorship program is another way that you can help us out. So any way you can help, keep the faucet running is what we're looking for.
And you'll see that on the bottom of the page, the last item is an invitation to pray for us. We believe that prayer is powerful, and we want to be the kind of organization that's just saturated by prayer. And so if you will tick that item off, we, with Shane and Amanda, you guys raise your hand a little higher this time so they can see you guys, and their 2 sons, Micah and Icy, who are here, they have bracelets on them, like the ones that Rich and I are wearing. And we would love to put these on your wrist. We'd love for you to take them for your kids, for your grandkids, for whoever you might want to put one on their wrist. And then anytime you're washing your hands, think of the story that I told when you see that bracelet. And pray for Inca Link. Pray for the youth of Latin America that they could have an encounter with the one who gives water that will satisfy them forever. that's our biggest prayer. We also wanted to just end this time showing a video of the impact Inca Link has had in the last 10 years.
You want to make a difference in the world, but at times it's hard to know where to start. We have been there too, overwhelmed by the need, but we started with what we could do today. In just one decade alone, Inca Link has been able to share the gospel with 2.2 million people in Latin America, seeing 151,000 decide to follow Jesus. Through 15 ministries in 7 countries, Jesus' love has been seen through meeting practical needs such as food and water, a safe place to play, grow, and learn, and ultimately to hear about the God who loves each and every one of them. But these 2.2 million lives received this hope, not by the few, but by the many. The Inca Link missionaries have chosen to devote their lives to live in community with the people in Latin America through unwavering compassion, divine connections, and relentless service. The boots on the ground are supported and encouraged by the thousands that have put their faith into action. Some have given their time as several short-term teams bring hope and encouragement each year to the ministries. Countless have given their resources and finances to sustain and create environments where we can meet one need at a time, causing a ripple effect into reaching communities. Each person that moves, goes, and gives to Inca Link supports our mission to reach the 300 million youth of Latin America with the irresistible love of Jesus. Without our Inca Link partners, these 2.2 million lives may have never had access to the gospel. Become an Inca Link partner. Let's reach millions more.
As we conclude this time, we just want to thank you for having us. And as you pray for us, we have prayer cards, or actually magnets for your fridge with our picture on it. Lisa and I are nomads today, so we go 1 week to 3 months to each country of Latin America. We go with a carry-on suitcase everywhere and stay in people's homes or guest houses, Airbnbs. And you can be praying for us as the Lord takes us, goes before us. And thanks for having us today.
Lisa, let me pray. Let me pray for you. Pray. Father, thank you so much for Rich and Elisa. Thank you for the vision that you've given them and for the work they're doing throughout Latin America. Father, we think of just that number, 300 million youth. What a huge number. Yet the idea of reaching them one by one on the ground with staff and volunteers and partners, we just thank you for the work. Pray for Rich and Elisa as they travel. I know the next month is full as they hit the road this week, and just fill them with energy and peace. And I pray as we think about a Barnabas community, how we can get involved, that we would respond and find ways to encourage them and pray with them as they move on. Thank you, Lord, in your name. Amen. Amen.